Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Our topic today is about the basis and dimension. So adjective, your adjective. So you will be able to identify whether a set of vectors is a basis for a vector space or not, and determine the dimension of a vector space. And dimension ni senang je lah. Okay, so definition of basis. Okay, so for a set of vector V1, V2, Vn to be a basis of a vector space V, it must be satisfies these two conditions. So first, the set of this vector must be linearly independent, and the set of this vector must span V. Okay, so linearly independent, macam mana hari tu condition dia? Okay, so for the linearly independent, then the combination of this set of vector, okay, so C1 V1 plus C2 V2 plus dot 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 plus V CN VN is equal to 0. Okay, so for this combination, which is equal to 0, this one will implies C1 equal to C2 equal to dot 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 until Cn is equal to 0. So kalau kita boleh tunjukkan C1, C2 until Cn equal to 0, so this set of vector, okay, so this set of vector is linearly independent. Okay, so number 2 for the span. Okay, so for the spanning vector, so this set of vector span vector space V if the linear combination of this set of vector so will produce a vector in vector space V. Okay, so this vector element in vector space V. Okay, so meaning that if you can get the solution of C1, C2 until Cn, okay, that will produce the vector in vector space V. So therefore, this set of vector span V. Okay. Okay, so kalau tak ada solution, dia tak span lah. Okay. Okay, so for the dimension. Okay, so if a vector space V has a basis of n vectors, okay, so vector space V ni ada basis yang mempunyai n vectors, sebagai contoh atas tadi tu. Okay, so katakan ni adalah basis untuk vector space V ni. So dia ada n vector 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sampai n. So ada n vector. So therefore, the dimension of vector space V is equal to n. Okay. So the value of n here is called the dimension of vector space V, and written as dim V. So dim tu dimension lah. Okay. Okay, so and then if V consists of the zero vector only, so maksudnya vector space V dia hanya zero vector, dia tak ada vector yang lain, then the dimension of vector space V is zero. Okay, so here the easier way to find the dimension of vector space V. Okay, usually for the vector space V which is consists of Rn. Okay, so Rn ni maksudnya dalam bentuk koordinat. For example, this one. Okay, so this one R2. Okay, so this one R3. Okay, so R3, R2. So R2 kita ada 2 element. R3 we have 3 element. If Rn, so inside this one we have n element. So therefore the dimension of vector space V this one is equal to n. Okay, so second, if the vector space V consists of polynomial of degree n, okay, so the polynomial has this form. Okay, so korang tahulah polynomial tu bentuknya macam mana. So the x power of 1, x power of 2 until x power of 3, 4, 5 until x power of n. So then the dimension of V is equal to n plus 1. Okay, so kenapa tambah dengan 1? Okay, so for example P2. Okay, so P2 is A node plus A1x plus A2x square. Okay, so n is 2. Okay, so number of term here, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we have 3 terms. N is 2. So, therefore, the dimension of V is n plus 1. Okay, so senang cerita untuk vector space yang terdiri daripada polinomial ni. Dia adalah bilangan term dia. Okay, so berapa term? Okay. Nak kira dia sama dengan berapa term lah. Kat sini kita ada 3 term. Ataupun senang cerita, we have the highest power, this one is 2. So therefore the number of term is 2 plus 1, which is 3. Another example, P3. So P3 A node plus A1x plus A2x square plus A3x cube. Okay. So the highest power is 3, but number of term is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so therefore the dimension of V for P3 is 4, n plus 1, which is 3 plus 1, 4. Okay, so for the matrix, if the vector space V consists of matrix, so then the dimension of V is equal to m times by n, the size of m. Okay, so the matrix of size m times n, so therefore the dimension is m times n. Okay, so number element in the matrix. For example, if vector space V is the 2 by 3 or 3 by 2, okay, so A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, so this one 2 by 3. Okay, so 2 by 3, 2 row 3 column. So dimension dia is equal to 6. Okay, ataupun number element dia 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so 6. Sama juga yang lain. Okay, for example this one, 1, 2, 3 until we have N. Okay, so sebaris ni kita ada N element. Sampai ke bawah kita ada M element. So dimension dia N times by M or M times by N. Okay, so example for the basis. Okay, so dalam ni saya tak tunjuk lah kira dimension tu macam mana, sebab memang dia akan fokus pada ni je. Cara dia memang gini je lah. So, kalau korang nampak Rn, tulis dimension dia n. Kalau nampak Pn, tulis dimension dia n plus 1. Kira macam tu je. Tak ada jalan kerja sangat, okay? Okay, so example for the basis. Okay, so determine whether the set S this one is basis for M 2 by 2 or not. Okay, so first linearly independent or not. Okay, so to check the linearly independent, so the linear combination of these four vector, okay, so kita ada 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so the linear combination of these three vector will produce 0 vector. Okay, so 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so take out all the coefficient, the equation here. So 3C1 plus 0C2. Okay, so 3C1 plus 0C2 plus 0C3 plus 1C4 is equal to 0. Okay, so untuk elemen yang pertama. For the second element, 0C1, okay, 0, negative 1C2, so negative C2, negative 8C3, so negative 8C3, negative 2C4, negative 2C4 is equal to 0. And then third element, 0, 0, minus 4C3, so minus 4C3, and then here 1C4, so 1C4 equal to 0. And last element, 0, 0, negative 20C3, okay, so negative 20C3, and negative 4C4 equal to 0. Okay, so we have this equation 4. Okay, so 4 equation, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4 constant C1, C2, C3, and C4. Okay, so we need to solve the value for C1, C2, C3, and C4. Okay, so easiest way, so usually we transform into a matrix equation. So we have this matrix A, 3, 0, 0, 0, 0, negative 1, negative 8, negative 2, 0, 0, negative, and so on. This one is the matrix for the coefficient of C, and this one matrix B. Okay, to solve this C, okay, so for this one, this matrix A is square matrix. Okay, so square matrix A, so square matrix which is 4 by 4. Okay, so 4 kali 4. Okay, so therefore we can use the method of determinant, which is AC is equal to B. Okay, so and then times by A inverse. C is equal to A inverse B. Okay, so therefore we need to show that the A inverse is exist. Okay, so kita tunjukkan inverse matrix A ni wujud. Okay, sekadar tunjukkan dia wujud sudah. Tak payah nak kira sampai habis pun tak apa. Okay. Okay. Okay, so in order to show this inverse exists, okay, so the inverse of A exists, so we must use the method of determinant. Okay, so sebab apa? Sebab tadi A ni adalah square matrix. Okay. Okay, so then find the determinant of matrix A. So here I choose the first column. Okay, so first column. So I use the first column. So 3 times negative 1, first element, which is 1 plus 1. So first row, first column. So negative 1 power of 1 plus 1. And then close this one. Okay, and then determinant of negative 1, negative 8, negative 2, 0, negative 4, 1, and so on. Then for the rest, this one 0, 0, 0. Okay, so since it is 0, so I didn't calculate lah. So only kita ada hanya yang ni sahaja. And then, so for the determinant for this matrix inside this one, so I choose again the first column. Okay, so 3 times negative 1 power of 2. Okay, so this one positive 1. So 3 times 1, 3. And then for this one, negative 1. Then negative 1 power of. Okay, so since this one is first row, first column, so 1 plus 1. And then close first row and first column. So we have determinant of negative 4, 1, negative 2, negative 20, and negative 4. Okay, so therefore from this one, okay, so negative 1 power of 2 positive, so here negative 1. Multiply this one, negative 4 times negative 4, 16, and minus negative 20 times 1, which is negative 20, so plus by 20. So we have the answer is negative 108. Okay, so since determinant of A is not equal to 0, so the set is linearly independent. Okay. Sebab determinan dia tak kosong, so kita boleh cari jawapan untuk C. Okay. So biasanya C is equal to inverse of A since B is the zero matrix. Okay. So therefore C, okay, so the matrix times by zero, the answer is zero. Okay. So we can say that C1 is equal to 0, C2 also equal to 0, C3 equal to 0, and C4 equal to 0. So that's why when the determinant of A is not equal to 0, so the inverse exists and the set is linearly independent. And then for the spanning set, okay, so spanning set or not, okay, so same as in linearly independent, only the linear combination of this one is equal to A, B, C, D. Okay, so A, B, C, D ni nak dapat daripada mana? Kita tengok tadi, vector space dia adalah M2 by 2. So, M2 by 2 this one is A, B, C, D. Okay, so adalah matrik bersaiz 2 kali 2. Apapun matrik yang bersaiz 2 kali 2. So, kita tulis sebagai A, B, C, D. Okay, so take out the equation. So we have this 4 equation. Okay, Okay, so dia lebih kurang sama je dengan linearly independent. Cuma beza kat sini je. A, B, C, D. So we have the matrix B here, A, B, C, D. And again here, we have the matrix A, which is a square matrix. And from 1, daripada 1, the determinant of A is not equal to 0. So the system of linear equation A, C equal to B has a consistency or unit solution. Okay, so kita boleh cari dia punya solution dia, which is C. C is equal to A inverse B. Okay. So therefore, since we have the solution of C1, C2, C3 and C4, hence S spans the vector space of M2 by 2, and since the set S satisfies both condition for the basis, hence set S is a basis for M2 by 2. Okay, so another example. Okay, so this one, vector space of polynomial of degree 2. Okay, so for this question, so we have a set of the vector which is 1 plus x. Okay, so 1 plus x, x plus x square and 1 plus x square. Okay, so show that this set of vectors is a basis of P2. Okay, so first we check for the linearly independent or not. Okay, so to check the linearly independent, so we write down these three vectors in term of linear combination. Here equal to 0. So C1, C2 and C3. And then collect for the first one. Okay, so take out the equation. Okay, so for the first equation is the for the constant. So here we have C1 times 1. And then here there is no constant. So C2 times 0, so 0. Okay, so C1 times 1, C1. And then here 1. So C3 times by 1, so C3. Okay, so for the first this one, for the constant. Okay, so for the second one, coefficient of x. So coefficient of x, so here we have x, so C1 times 1, C1. And here also have x, coefficient is 1, so 1 times C2, so we have C2. And then here there is no x, so therefore for the C3, 0, is equal to 0. Then coefficient of x square. Okay, so coefficient of x square, so for the first one, there is no x square, so 0. Here we have x square, coefficient is 1, so 1 times C2, so we have C2. And then here coefficient of, we have here x square, so the coefficient of x square is 1. So 1 times by C3, okay. So we have plus C3, which is equal to 0. And then write down in term of matrix equation. Okay. Okay, so this one A, C equal to B. Okay. So in order to solve the coefficient C1, C2 and C3, and since A is the square matrix, so we search the determinant of A. So kita tunjukkan determinant of A ni exist, wujud. Okay, so kalau determinant of A ni wujud, so kita boleh selesaikan C. Okay, so kalau siapa tak nak buat determinant, gunalah apa tu, Gauss-Jordan elimination method. So buat augment matrix 1 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 0. So nanti korang akan dapat dekat sini C1, C2, C3 sama dengan 0. Okay, so tapi kita ada cara yang singkat. Nah, kita pakailah, okay. So just enough to show the determinant of A is not equal to 0. So calculate of determinant of A. Okay, so here I use, saya gunakan 1, 3, first row. Okay, so first row, so 1 times negative 1. Here first row, set first column, so 1 plus 1. And then close first row and first column, we have 1, 0, 1, 1. So determinant of 1, 0 and 1, 1. Plus, so second is 1, 0, so I didn't calculate. And next is 1, plus by 1, negative 1 power of, so this one, first row, third column, so 1 plus 3. And then close first row and third column, so we have determinant of 1, 1, 0, 1. Okay, and then we have the determinant of A, which is equal to 2. Okay, so since the determinant of A is not equal to 0, so thus the set of vector is linearly independent. And then next for the spanning. Okay, so we check whether the set S is a spanning set or not. Okay, so same linear combination of the three vector this one. Okay, so C1, C2, C3, and this time is equal to A node U A1X plus A2X2. Okay, so this one we got it from where? So because from P2. Okay, so P2 polynomial of degree 2. Okay, so general form of the polynomial of degree 2, we have A node plus A1X plus A2X square. So A ni tak kisahlah, korang boleh je pakai variable yang lain. Korang boleh pakai A, B, C pun boleh. Okay, so tak nak pakai A, B, C, pakai yang lain pun boleh. Cuma korang kena tahu, kalau polynomial degree 2 ni, we have the general form dia, constant, and then x square. If P3, constant, x square, and then another one, x3. Okay. Okay, and then take out the equation here. So 1, 2, 3. So first one for the constant. So for the constant, we have 1C1, here 0C2, and here 1C3 is equal to A node. And then coefficient of X, 1C1, 1C2, and here there is no X, 0C3 is equal to A1. And then coefficient of X square, here there is no X square, so 0. And here 1C2, and then 1C3 is equal to A2. Okay, and then transform into matrix equation. So we have this form A, C, B. Okay, so this one also same as in linearly independent yang atas tadi. Okay, so in order to solve this matrix C, okay, so we use the inverse method. C is equal to A inverse B. Okay, so cara nak selesaikan. Okay, so in order to solve this one, so inverse of A must be exist. Okay, so to show the inverse of A must be exist, we must show that the determinant of A is not equal to 0. Okay, so sebab dia kat sini ni adalah square matrix. Okay, so tapi kalau dia bukan square matrix, kita tak boleh pakai inverse method lah. Okay, kena pakai yang lagi satu tu, Gauss-Jordan elimination method. Panjanglah sikit teknik dia, okay. Yeah, so here since from 1 we have the determinant of A which is equal to, which is not equal to 0, so thus the system of linear equation AC equal to B has a consistency or unique solution, hence set S spans P2. Okay, so since the set S satisfy both condition for basis, hence set S is a basis for P2. Okay, so this one example of a question. So contoh-contoh soalan. Okay, soalan dalam exam lah, contoh-contoh dia macam ni. Okay, so consider a set S which is equal to these three vector, so 1, 2, 3. Okay, so it's a question, state to condition so that S is a basis for R3. Okay, so for the first condition, okay, so for this one, first condition, set S must be linearly independent. Independent. And then second, set S spans vector space R3. Okay, so this one two condition. And then number two, determine whether the set S is a basis for R3 or not. Okay, so first we check for the linearly independent. Okay, so for the linearly independent, so we write down the these three vector in the form of linear combination. So C1, 1, 2, negative 1 plus C2, 3, negative 1, 2 plus C3, 3, 6, negative 3 is equal to 0, 0, 0. Okay, so R3. So R3 we have 0. Okay, 0, 0, 0, 0. And then take out the equation. Okay, so from this one we have 1C1. Okay, so kalau siapa yang tak nampak, tulis lah. Okay, so C1, 2C1, negative C1 plus 3C2 minus C2, 2C2 plus 3C3, 6C3 and negative 3C3, which is equal to 0, 0, 0. Okay, so from this one, okay, so we take the first element, so C1 plus 3C2. Okay, so C1 plus 3C2 and then plus 3C3. So which is equal to 0. And then second element, 2C1. C1 and then plus minus, so minus C2. Then plus 6C3 is equal to 0. And then third element, negative C1. Then plus 2C2. Okay, so plus 2C2. And then plus negative 3C3. So minus 3C3, which is equal to 0. And then convert into matrix equation. So we have here 1, 3, 3. So 1, 3, 3, 2, negative 1, 6, 2, negative 1, 6, and then negative 1, 2, negative 3. Okay. And then the coefficient, which is a coefficient lah, the variable, which is C1, C2, and C3 is equal to 0, 0, 0. Okay, so this one is the matrix A, this one is square matrix. Okay, so since it is a square matrix, so we can use the method of determinant. Okay, so find the determinant of matrix A in order to solve C1, C2, and C3. Okay, so because by find the determinant, If the determinant is not equal to 0, so we can solve matrix C, which is equal to A inverse times by B. Okay. Okay, so find the determinant of matrix A. Okay, so here I choose. Nah, ni tak boleh lah sebab tak ada kosong, tak banyak kosong kan. So pilih je lah mana-mana. So I choose first row. Okay, so determinant of A. So first row 1, negative 1 power of 1 plus 1, determinant of, okay, so close first row and first column, negative 1, 6, so negative 1, 6, 2 and negative 3, and then plus, second element is 1, 3, okay, so 3, so 3 in the first row, second column. So negative 1 power of 1 plus 2 and then determinant of, so close first row and second column, 2, 6, negative 1, negative 3. So 2, 6, negative 1 and negative 3 and then plus another 3, negative 1 power of first row third column, so 1 plus 3 times by determinant of. Okay, so first row close first row and third column, 2, negative 1, negative 1, 2. Okay, so and then calculate. So we have here equal to 1, negative 1 power of 2, so positive. Okay, so positive 1. And then determinant of this matrix, negative 1 times negative 3, which is 3, minus 6 times 2, which is 12. And then plus negative 1 power of 3, so negative. So 3 times negative 1, so minus 3. So determinant of this one, 2 times negative 3, negative 6. Okay, so 6 times negative 1, and then minus negative 6. And then last one, 3, negative 1 power of 4, which is positive. Okay, so positive 3. Okay, so determinant of this one, 2 times 2, 4, minus by negative 1 times negative 1, positive 1. So we have here 1, 3 times negative 3 minus 12, so become negative 9. 9, 1, 2, 2, okay, so negative 9. And then here negative 6 plus 6, 0, so 0 times negative 3, 0 lah. And then this one plus 3, 4 minus 1 is 3. So plus by 3 times 3 is 9, so which is equal to 0. Okay, so since the determinant of A is equal to 0, since determinant of A is equal to 0, therefore inverse matrix of A does not exist. So tak exist. So set S, okay, so set of the vector S, this one is not linearly independent. Okay, so since the first condition is not satisfied, therefore S is not a basis for R3. Okay, so dia bukan basis untuk R3 sebab condition yang linearly independent ni dia tak satisfies. Okay, so another example and another question. Okay, so this one, consider a set S 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and 0, 1, 2. So, determine whether the set S form a basis for R3. Okay, so first we check for the linearly independent. Okay, so, linearly independent. Okay, so kita tengok yang ni. Okay, so first write down this the combination of these three vector is equal to 0. So C1, 2, okay, so C1, 2, 1, 1, plus C2, 1, 1, 1, plus C3, 0, 1, 2 is equal to 0, 0, 0. Okay. Okay, so and then take out the equation. Okay, so we have here 2C1 C1 C1. Okay, so kembangkan. Okay, so siapa yang tak nampak nak keluarkan equation tu, kembangkan dulu. So plus C2 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 and then plus, okay, so this one 0, 0 times C3 0 lah. And then C3 2C3 is equal to 0, 0, 0. And then take out the equation. So we have from the first element, okay, so 2C1 plus C2 plus 0 equal to 0. Okay, so we have 2C1 plus C2 plus 0 equal to 0. And then second element, C1, okay, so second element, C1 plus C2, and then plus C3 is equal to 0. And then third element, we have C1 plus C2, and then plus 2C3 is equal to 0. And then transform into matrix equation. So we have 2, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, and then 1, 1, 2. And here the constant C1, C2, and C3 is equal to 0, 0, 0. Okay, A, C, B. Okay, so this one is the square matrix. So again, we can use the method of determinant. Okay, so kita boleh tunjukkan determinant of A itu equal to 0 or not. Okay, so tapi ini saya tak nak guna yang tadi lah, sebab tadi dah 3 soalan saya buat cara yang sama kan. Okay, so this time I use the Gauss-Jordan elimination method lah. Okay, so for the Gauss-Jordan elimination method, okay, so first we take out the augmented matrix. Okay, so we have 2, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, and here 0, 0, 0. Okay, so first we need to have here the leading one here. Okay, so nak kena ada leading one. Okay, so since here we have 1, okay, so saya transform dia ke atas. Okay, so interchange. So I interchange row 1 and row 3. So I have 1, 1, 2, and here 1, 1, 1, and here is 2, 1, 0. Okay, so yang ni pun interchange lah, 0, 0. Okay, so tapi sebab dia kosong, kosong, tak defect sangat lah. Okay, so kalau dia nombor, kita kena ubah. Okay, and then, so here already leading 1. Okay, and then make it this one become 0, and this one become 0. Okay, so to make it second row become 0. Okay, so tadi sebelum tu, so korang boleh juga interchange row 1 and row 2. Tak ada masalah, okay. So ni saya nak pilih row 1 dengan row 3. Okay, tak kisah nak guna row 1 dengan row 2 pun boleh. Okay, so next make it this one 0 and here 0. Okay, so you can do it simultaneously. Okay, so for the second row 2 minus by row 1 and put back at a row number 2. And then for the third row, so row 3 minus 2 row 1 and put back at a row number 3. So we have here first row didn't change. Okay, so 1, 1, 2, 0. And then second row, row 2 minus row 1. 1 minus 1, 0. And then 1 minus 1, 0. And then 1 minus 2, negative 1, and here 0, 0 minus 0 is 0. And then row 3 minus 2 row 1. Okay, so 2 minus by 2 times 1, 0. And then 1 minus by 2 times 1, so 1 minus 2, which is negative 1. And then 0 minus by 2 times by 2, which is negative 4. So 0 minus negative 4. Okay, so 0 minus negative 4. Okay, so negative 1. So okay, here negative 4. And then here 0 minus 0, 0. And then make it here leading 1. But we don't have any number here, but because here is 0. So since here we have 1, so I can interchange row 2 and row 3. Okay, so row 2 interchange with row 3. And then simultaneously I can multiply with negative. Okay, so tapi tak apalah, biarlah dulu. Okay, so I have here 1, 1, 2, 0, 0, negative 1, negative 4, and here is 0, and here 0, 0, negative 1, 0. Okay, so from this one, okay, and then make it this one leading one. So since here negative one, so make it become positive one. Okay, so negative row two and put back at row two. So I have 1, 1, 2, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 4, and 0, 0, -1. Okay, so this one actually I can do simultaneously. Okay, so negative 1 make it become 1. So row number 3 times with negative and put back at row number 3. So this one become positive. Okay, so positive 1. And then make it this one become 0 and this one also become 0. Okay, so to make it this one 0 and 0. So I use row 1 minus by 2 row 3 and put back at row number 1. And row number 2 minus by 4 row 3 and put back at row number 2. Okay, so we have here 0, 0, 1, 0, second row 0, and then 1 minus 4 times 0 is 1, 4 minus by 4 times 1, 0, and then 0 minus by negative 4 times 0, okay, 0. Then for the first row, row 1 minus 2 row 3, so 1 minus by 2 times 0, 1, then 1 minus 2 times 0, 1, and then 2 minus by 2 times 1 is 0, and here 0 minus by 2 times 0 is 0. And then make it this one become 0, which is row 1 minus row 2. Okay, so row 1 minus row 2, and put back at a row 1. Okay, so I have here 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, for the first row, 1 minus 0, 1, 1 minus 1, 0, 0 minus 0, 0, and 0 minus 0 is 0. Okay, so from this matrix, we can show that. Okay, so this one for the first one, C1, C2, and C3. Okay, so we can show C1 is equal to 0, C2 is equal to 0, and C3 is equal to 0. So therefore, set S is linearly independent. Okay, so cara ini panjanglah sikit eh. Okay, so next. Okay, so sebenarnya saya ada salah, ada mistake kat sini kan. Okay, so this one actually Z0, 0 oh, 0, C3. Betul, 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 tak ada. Okay, so tak ada. Okay. Okay, so after check the linearly independent, so next we check for the span. Second, spanning set or not. Okay, so same for the spanning set. Okay, so we write down the linear combination C1 2, 1, 1 plus C2 1, 1, 1 plus C3 0, 1 2 is equal to, okay, so this one A, B, C. Okay, so R3. Okay, so R3. Okay, and then take out the equation. So we have 2C1 sama macam yang kat atas tadi, plus C2 plus 0 is equal to A, and then C1 plus C2 then plus C3 is equal to B, and C1 plus C2 plus 2C3 is equal to C. And then take out the matrix. Okay, so transform into a matrix equation. So we have 2 1 0 1 1 1 1 1 2, C1 C2 C3 is equal to ABC. Okay, and then take out the augmented matrix. Okay, so sebab saya nak guna apa ni namanya, Gauss-Jordan elimination method. Okay. Okay, so Gauss-Jordan elimination method, take out the augmented matrix. Okay, so kalau nak guna matrix yang determinant tu pun boleh, yang atas tu. Okay, so ini saya tunjukkan contoh. Okay, so determinant, bukan determinant, apa, Gauss-Jordan elimination method. Okay, so take out the augmented matrix. So 2 1 0 1 1 1 1 1 2, and here A B C. Okay, so make it this one as leading 1. Okay, so I interchange row 2 and row 1. Okay, so 1 1 1 2 1 0 1 1 2, and here is B A C. After that, make it this one become 0 and this one become 0. Okay, so using row 2 minus 2 row 1 and put back at row number 2, and row 3 minus row 1 put back at row number 3. So we have here. Okay, so first row didn't change, so 1 1 1 B. Second row, 2 minus 2 times by 1, 0. Then 1 minus by 2 times 1, negative 1. Then 0 minus by 2 times 1, negative 2. And then A minus by 2 times B, so A minus 2 B. Then third row, 1 minus 1, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. 2 minus 1 is 1. And then C minus B. Okay. And then make it this one as leading 1, multiplying with negative. So negative row 2 put back at row number 2. So we have 1, 1, 1. Here B. And here is 0, 1, 2. And here is 2B minus A. And here is 0, 0, 1, C minus B. And then next, make it this one become 0, and this one become 0. Okay, so row 1 minus row 3, and put back at row number 1. And here row 2 minus 2 row 3, and put back at row number 2. Okay, so we have row 1 minus row 3. So 1 minus 0 is 1. 1 minus 0 is 1. 1 minus 1, 0. Then B minus C minus B. Okay, so B minus, okay, so B minus C minus B. So we have B minus C plus B. So 2B minus C. Okay, so 2B minus C. Okay, so 2B minus C. And then second row, so row 2 minus 2 row 3. So 0 minus 2 times 0, 0. 1 minus 2 times 0 is 1. And then 2 minus by 2 times 1, 0. And then 2B minus A minus by 2 times C minus B. So we have 2B minus A minus 2C plus 2B. Okay, so 2B plus 2B, 4B. Okay, so this one 4B minus A minus 2C. Okay, so 4B minus A minus 2C. 4B minus A minus 2C. 4B minus A minus 2C. Okay, so 4B minus A minus 2C. And third row didn't change, so 0, 0, 1. And C minus B. And then make it this one become 0. Okay, so by using row 1 minus row 2 and put back at row number 1. So we have here 1 minus 0 is 1. 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 minus 0 is 0, then 2bc minus 4b minus a minus 2c. Okay, so we have 2b minus 4b, which is negative 2b, and then minus a, so negative c minus negative 2c, so become plus what, plus c. Okay, so minus c plus 2c, so plus c, and then 0 minus negative a, so plus a. Okay, and then here 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, and here 4b minus a minus 2c, and here is c minus b. Okay, so we have the solution here. Okay, so we have c1 is equal to negative 2b plus c plus a. C2, keluar apa pula ni? Okay, so C2 is equal to 4b minus a minus 2c, and C3 is equal to c minus b. Okay, okay, so therefore set S is, okay, so set S span R3. So since both condition is satisfied, so S is basis for R3. Okay, hilang pula. Okay, so kalau dia bukan basis, so kalau bukan basis, contohlah dalam dua condition tadi, kalau yang atas tu for this one, okay, so yang atas ni, okay, so yang atas tu korang akan dapat bentuk dia macam ni ya. Okay, so yang ni tadi korang akan ada 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. So kalau dapat bentuk macam ni, this one linearly independent. Okay, linearly independent. So kalau dia bukan linearly independent, so orang akan dapat bentuk macam ni. 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so yang bawah ni korang akan dapat semua kosong. So this one linearly dependent. Okay, so kalau dalam yang span tadi, so korang akan dapat macam ni. Kat sini adalah contoh 4b minus 2a, c minus b, and suddenly here 2 minus 2c, 2c minus 3b. Okay, korang akan dapat kosong sini, tapi dekat sini 2b minus 3c. Okay, so this one not span. Okay, so not span. Okay, okay, so that's all for basis and dimension. Okay, so any question you can PM me. Okay, so in WhatsApp. So that's all for our lesson today. See you later. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.